Apple just announced their new macOS called Catalina. And this macOS comes with a feature where you can use your iPad as a second monitor. So let's see whether this feature is any good. Intro. What up guys, welcome back to another episode. My name is Eddie Bear and today we will talk about the new sidecar feature of the macOS Catalina. A while ago I already made a tutorial on how you can turn your iPad with the help of the Luna display into a second monitor. In today's video we will take a comparative look at the sidecar feature of macOS Catalina and we will find out whether companies like Wacom and Astro HQ, the manufacturer of the Luna display, should be nervous about the new sidecar feature. Also, let me point out two side notes at this point. I can only compare the sidecar feature from macOS Catalina with the Luna display in combination with the AstroPad Studio, cause I don't own a Wacom tablet. And also, this is an early beta feature of the new macOS, so this will not represent the final product, and Apple is known to improve the software over the course of the beta program, so probably the sidecar feature will deviate from the one you will actually experience in the fall when macOS Catalina is released. In order for you to use sidecar, you need a Mac, an Apple TV, or an iPad. The Mac has to run on the latest macOS Catalina, and the iPad has to run on iOS 13. The Apple TV, on the other hand, needs the latest tvOS. To connect to these devices, you need an active Wi-Fi connection or you can use a lightning cable. To establish a sidecar connection, head over to your system preferences, select sidecar, and here you can now choose the device you want to connect to. Once you select the device, your display will flicker for a moment and the connection will be established. Let's take a closer look at the iPad and see what features we get with sidecar. First of all, you will notice that you not only get an extended desktop, you also get two sidebars. For example, the sidebar on the left gives you an option to toggle your dock from one desktop to another, and you can also engage the keyboard of your iPad, or you can use certain shortcuts like the command key, option, and so forth. One of my favorite parts of sidebar is the fact that you get an active touch bar on your iPad, meaning you have the same functionality that you know and love from the MacBook, you can also now enjoy on your iPad. The full potential of sidecar is unleashed in combination with an Apple Pencil. The Pencil's performance, even at this early stage, is impressive. It's very responsive and it translates the position and pressure accurately. Unfortunately, the only thing you don't get in sidecar is touch support. I mean, Apple, come on, it's right there. Why can't I use my fingers to close a window or something? I have to pick up the pencil and make the window go away? Come on. So with all these positive things, does that mean you should sell your Wacom tablet and your Luna display and cancel your AstroPad Studio subscription right away? At this point, my answer would be maybe. Sidecar is missing certain features that other solutions offer, for example, like smart gestures, and I don't want to beat the dead horse, but touch would be really great in sidecar, Apple. But let's get back to the smart gestures. So smart gestures enable you to use your fingers in combination with the Apple Pencil, for example, under Luna display, so I can predefine certain actions. So for example, if I'm using two fingers and my Apple Pencil, I can bring up the brush menu and adjust my brush as I want it to. Also, if I tap with two fingers, I'm undoing my last task. Such features can be really helpful in your daily routine and it will speed up your workflow massively. At this moment, if you're using Sidecar, you still need access to a keyboard and nobody wants to always bring up the iPad keyboard in order to undo what they just did in Photoshop. Another thing with Sidecar is that the resolution of your workspace is predefined, you cannot adjust it. With Luna display, you actually can choose between different resolutions, which will give you a bigger real estate and can help you with especially wide or big projects. If I'm comparing the latency between the Luna display and Sidecar, while I'm only connected to the Wi-Fi, you can see that Sidecar is pretty much crushing it with the latency. The moment you plug your iPad into your Mac, the latency of the Luna display is increased massively, but still Sidecar is faster when it comes to drawing than the Luna display. The only circumstance where Luna display outperforms Sidecar is actually under video playback. I noticed if you run a full screen video on your iPad under Sidecar, sometimes you get frame skips. If you run a full screen video under Luna display, it pretty much plays smoothly and there are no skips whatsoever. Apart from these things, it's hard to find any downsides on Sidecar, especially if you take into consideration that this is a free feature that comes now in stock with every macOS Catalina. And since a lot of us already have iPads at home, it's hard to justify the huge pile of cash you have to throw at solutions like Wacom or like the Luna display. But if I'm honest, I think I will for now stick with Luna display, cause it feels more natural to me to work with Luna display and Photoshop than with Sidecar, cause I have the magic gestures and it speeds up my editing process. If Apple extends the features under Sidecar, this could change in the future, especially with touch support. So what is your opinion about macOS Catalina Sidecar feature? Cause I know a lot of you have been waiting for a native support where you finally can turn your iPad into a second monitor or an extended desktop without the need to buy a certain software or hardware to accomplish this. Let me know down in the comments below, and also please tell me whether you would like to have more glimpses into the feature about macOS Catalina. So with that said, thanks again for watching and I see you guys in the next one.